According to the Centers for Disease Control and, I just gotta get this right, Disease Control and Prevention, more than 6 million children have asthma in the United States. It's because the children have smaller airways than adults, which we don't think about all the time, makes asthma very serious for them. So I want you to, if you would please, we have a 3D model up here that I'd like you to look at, and tell us a little bit more about asthma in children and the adults, and the differences that we see here between them.
Well, as you said, Ed, the bronchioles and the whole respiratory tract in children is smaller than adults. And basically in asthma, it's a reactive disease. So another name for asthma that we typically call is reactive airway disease. And it's basically that the airways are reacting to various different things. They either are reacting to inflammation from allergy, they can be reacting to infectious agents, they can be reacting to exposure to certain things in the environment. So it's a reactive airway disease where...
So that what you're showing us right now with the cursor, that airway right now, that's the one that... I mean, everything changes, of course, with children and adults, but that's the most affected part of the airway?
Yes, typically down in here. Okay. Asthma is a disease of the lower airway, of the respiratory tract. And what happens is if you think about an air filter, when we change our air filter, it's clean, air can flow in and out. In asthma or reactive airway disease, the bronchioles get very inflamed and full. And so they have a harder time for air to flow in and out, and therefore that makes breathing more difficult.